My name is London Cobbs. I go to Roosevelt High School. I'm attending North Dakota State College of Science next year. My favorite player is Arian Ferrar and Russell Westbrook.
All right. And then Ramon Hudnell, shooting guard, Patrick Henry, Rochester Community College commit, favorite player, James Freaky Harden. There you go.
Chris Buckley, Coon Rapids High School, point guard, number two. We'll be attending Wabanese Community College next year in Illinois. Favorite player, Michael Jordan.
My name is Stephen Kennedy. I play the point guard for Patrick Henry High School. I'm undecided, and my favorite player is Stephen Curry.
My name is Marquise Walker. I play 4 and 5. I'm going to Eastern Arizona College, and my favorite player is, I'd say, Kevin Durant. And I went to Lakeville North.
Marty Hill, go to Chamber Park. I play point guard, shooting guard. I'm going Northeast Nebraska, and my favorite player is James Harden.
I'm John Warren. I play the 1 and the 2. I went to Hopkins High School. I'm attending Augustana College next year, and my favorite player will be Paul George.
Arian Ferrar Jr., 6 foot, went to Roosevelt High School, is on my way to North Dakota College of Science. And my favorite player is Kobe Bryant.
Okay, hello, my name is Eric Elliott. I'll be attending Williston State. I went to Johnson High School. I'm a small forward and shooting guard. And my favorite player would be LeBron James.
My name is Darian Butler. I play small forward. And I went to Augsburg Fairview Academy, and my college is unknown yet.
Who's your favorite player?
LeBron James.
Mola Wall, guard, Breck School, going to the University of Pennsylvania. And my favorite player is Derrick Rose.
I'm Jerome Dixon. I go to Armstrong High School, point guard. I'm going to Dakota County Technical College next year. My favorite player is probably Russell Westbrook.
I'm Justice Murphy. I'm a forward. My high school is Johnson High School in St. Paul. I'm going to Lake Region in North Dakota, and my favorite player is LeBron.
Abdulsalan Osman. I play 4 and 5, St. Paul Academy, Hartnell College, and LeBron James.
I'm Sid Tomes. I play the 1 or the 2. I'm going to Air Force Academy, and I went to Eastridge High School, and my favorite player is Steph Curry.
All right, Jakarius Ford, Patrick Henry, point guard, College Rochester. Favorite player? Allen Iverson.
My name is Jalen Mobley. I went to Johnson High School. I'm a point guard, and I will be attending Northeast Nebraska next year. And my favorite player is Carmelo Anthony.
Sean Burns from Armstrong High School. I played the small forward, power forward, and the center. My favorite player would have to be LeBron James, and the school I'm attending for college would be UMD.
I'm Jobriel Powell from Washburn High School. I play shooting guard slash point guard. I'm going to Dakota State University, and my favorite player would have to be LeBron James.
I'm Jarvis Johnson. I attended De La Salle High School. I'm going to University of Minnesota, and my favorite point guard in the NBA is Derrick Rose.
Welcome to the Inner City All-Star, 22nd annual Inner City All-Star Classic. This is Troy Russell. I'm here with Faith Johnson Patterson. Faith, this is going to be another awesome ball game like we had in our first game.
Yes, it is, and the guys look fired up. Now I'm going to be a little unbiased here because I got nephews on both sides, so I'm not sure which team I'm going for, wisdom or knowledge, but it should be a good one.
Well, it should be fun because both your nephews are outstanding players. One of your nephews, Jarvis Johnson, headed to the University of Minnesota, probably the top point guard in the state of Minnesota for the past year here.
That's right.
And then Arian Ferrar, your other nephew, who was a awesome point guard at Roosevelt High School.
And we got Allen Anderson in the building.
Allen Anderson is here. Allen Anderson from the New Jersey
Brooklyn
Nets, who is a big
Nets.
Time. Oh, sorry, they're the Brooklyn Nets now.
Yeah.
And he is a big time supporter of the game. I believe he bought the uniforms and the shoes for the kids every year, and he just comes back as an alumni.
Yeah.
Allen Anderson will get an interview with Allen at some point today. Hey, Allen. So we will get him at some point we'll get him up here and have a conversation with him. Jump ball here, Josh Collins. Uh-oh, right off the tip.
Nice pass by nice Jarvis pass. Johnson.
Jalen Mobley, one heck of a ball player out of Johnson. You know, that's almost, that's one heck of a, that's a D1 backcourt right there with Mobley and Johnson right there. That's
Arian Ferrar right there.
Arian Ferrar.
Nice no look pass by nice my play. Nephew.
Arian Ferrar.
Nice look.
Darian Butler with the finish. Jarvis Johnson to the basket, and he finished with the left hand.
Nice move. They're going at it. He's getting ready.
Arian Ferrar now with the ball, bringing
also
it up.
Also known as Wavy.
Turns it over.
Gets the ball stolen.
Jarvin Johnson ahead for three.
Nice pass.
For three.
Nice shot. That was Jovial Powell from Washburn.
Oh.
Back to back threes, number two. Oh my God, this is going to be hard
That's
to keep up with.
Chris Buckley from Coon Rapids.
Oh, Jarvis with the air ball. Unbelievable. I don't even know what to say about that. That is my nephew, but, you know, hey, he just warmed up. I thought it was an alley-oop. It looked like an alley-oop.
Yep, so we got Arian Ferrar now with the ball for three. And, oh.
Knee short.
Short. Inside. Nice
pass.
Nice finish.
This is going to be, it's 7-7 already. 14 points. Can you believe that? In 2 minutes. Unbelievable. Nice. Unbelievable. Josh, who is for three, his teammate. The quick shot by number six. Unbelievable. That's going to be, is that number six? I think he's got a new uniform.
Yeah, we got some uniform switches on us here, which is really throwing me off here. Just Jarvis Johnson with the ball.
We'll catch up to you in a few minutes.
And oh.
We had a foul, but he's trying to get a call.
Oh, Butler.
The dunk by Butler.
Darion Butler from the School of Recording Arts with the finish.
And that's also a uniform change.
Josh Collins with the ball. And De La Salle for three. Headed to Marquette.
Josh actually is going to North Dakota.
North Dakota, yeah, that's the other one. Sakars, well, yeah, they had so many of them. Outstanding players De La Salle this
and
year.
And he's not here. Uh-oh.
Oh,
throw
nice.
It down the dunk by number
That's
32.
Sean Burns for the Armstrong.
We got to get caught up here.
Oh, nice finish.
This is definitely above the rim and at a high
I believe that's
pace
Marquise.
Here.
I believe that's Marquise Walker that just finished at Lakeville North. That's Jalen Mobley.
From Johnson. The score already is 12-13, and it's only been 3 minutes up to this game. So we were looking, Jarvis Johnson.
Was that Jarvis for three?
For three.
Jarvis Johnson.
He made some adjustments with his shot.
With a quick 5 points. Oh,
the defense
stolen.
Right there. Jarvis Johnson pushes the ball off the floor.
Jarvis Johnson.
Got
Having
fun playing around.
Uh-oh. Oh, Jarvis with the steal. Oh, is he going to do? Oh, bad pass. Back out to Mobley for three. No good. Rebound by Marquise Walker. Arian Ferrar, oh, missed
oh,
the layup.
Short on the layup. Outlet pass to Jarvis Johnson.
Oh, no good.
Three is short.
Collins for three. Knocks it down.
Josh has got his three on today. That's two for him.
18-13 in favor of team knowledge over team wisdom so far. Oh,
wow.
What a shot.
Look at the three-point shooting. That was Chris Buckley from Coon Rapids.
Chris Buckley for three. Josh Collins again to the basket.
We expect this game to be above the rim. So far, it's beyond the three-point line. Unbelievable.
Subs already coming in the ball game.
Wow.
You have Justice Murphy, Jacarius Ford, Muhammad Lawal. Jerome Dixon, all checking in for Team Knowledge. Also checking, yep, Justice Murphy now with the ball. Jabril Powell, that kid's one heck of an athlete. Powell, he can really fly. Arian Farrar, nice pass ahead. Oh, nice pass for Arian Farrar.
Nice layup, nice finish.
Looks like that was Sid Tomes.
Oh, the
Ford
block.
Goes to the basket and gets it beat up.
What a block.
He just got his shot beat up there. Big
unbelievable.
Time.
Unbelievable. Wow.
Another.
We've got to get some adjustments here. Looks like they switched uniforms on us, so give us a few minutes here to get caught up with
who these guys are.
Here.
That's Powell for three, no good. Nice
pass.
Finish. Oh.
And the and one.
And one, number five. I believe that's John Warren from Hopkins is who I believe that is. Jabril Powell to the basket, no good. Pass the ball, alley-oop.
Oh, a little bit too hard, put too much on it.
And he waited too long.
I don't know,
uh-oh.
Right now we've got...
What's going to happen here?
Nice pass.
Nice pass, LaWall. LaWall from Breck with the ball.
Team Wisdom, it looks like they're running away with it. We got a block there. Team Knowledge looks like they
Wow, that's money. Oh no.
Unbelievable. It looks like we got the tip right there from Jerome Dixon. Quite a few Armstrong players here today.
Armstrong had a great team this year. They had a really good basketball team.
The shot by the lefty, and we're trying to see who that is. I'm not sure if there's Eric Elliott from
Jabril Powell for three. Man, that kid can flat out light it up when he gets hot.
Unbelievable. Nice pass.
Arian Farrar for three. No good. He left John Warren to the basket.
A nice step through move. That's the most popular move of the day is the step through. The Euro.
Powell over to Ford. Ford for three. No good. Back out to LaWall. LaWall for three, no good. Oh, Ford tries to dunk it back in. Nice pass, Arian Farrar.
What the left-hand no-look pass. He's been working on his passing skills, I see.
I believe that. Uh-oh. I believe that's Marty Hill.
Just taken
Team
over.
Wisdom. When they make subs, they look like it was these.
Wow.
Second group is not getting back on D.
Wow.
Jabril Powell to the basket.
The pace of this game is unbelievable.
Jabril Powell right back to the basket. Arian Farrar back with the ball again. I believe that's Marty Hill. Curious four.
The three is good from Jarcarius Ford of Henry. Rather, I believe that might have been Mohamed Lalawa from Brex. Got to get the numbers here right. We'll make the adjustments here quickly.
Yep, Ford with the ball. Ford again with the ball, shoots the three. Air ball.
Yes, short. Team Knowledge still comes back. Only down by four. We got a timeout or multiple substitutions in the game right now.
So 32-28 with 10 minutes to go. team wins them ahead 32-28. You know, what's interesting is all these guys are good-sized kids out here, man. This is going to be a very competitive ballgame. Jarvis Johnson ahead of Jalen Mobley.
What the steal? He came
Where
from
was
nowhere.
He at?
I thought he was
Did
out
he
of
come
bounds.
Off the bench?
He was out of bounds.
Oh, and he missed a layup.
He was out of bounds. He wasn't even in the game. Unbelievable.
Jarvis Johnson.
Islander and Josh Collins to Jarvis Johnson for the alley-oop.
Way above the rim.
He came from nowhere. I don't even think he was in the game.
I think he was on the bench and he was late sub.
Wow. What a defensive effort. Unbelievable.
Short. What was that? That one took the house down on that one.
Josh, but the hustle, he's rebounding everywhere. Unbelievable.
They're all overplay. I mean, it's up and down action.
Everyone's cherry picking today. Trying to get that dunk. Jarvis Johnson not paying attention. Almost got 3 points scored on him right there.
That was Marshawn Wilson.
No one's getting
Jalen
back down on defense.
Mobley.
Got a... That was partially tipped, I believe.
Oh, another turnover.
Finally, we can kind of get caught up here.
34-30 in favor of Team Wisdom. Again, we are in the first half of the 22nd annual Inter-City All-Star Classic. Jarvis Johnson
with the little runner.
That was my pick for MVP before it started to see if that holds up. It probably was everybody's pick though. Wasn't
well,
oh,
what,
there they go.
They're getting killed right now, so.
Well, they're only down four.
Jerome Dixon with the reverse.
Josh with the ball, Colin. Over to Jalen Mobley, back over to Jarvis Johnson. For three, Jarvis Johnson.
Put the fade away.
Somebody better guard him.
That looked like LeBron James right there. I got to give it to him. Nice shot.
Oh, right back at him.
Wow, this right is a three-point shooting contest.
This is a little bit more scoring in this game than it was in the girls' game. A lot less defense.
Unbelievable.
A lot less defensive intensity.
Unbelievable.
Oh, almost again.
Jarvis Johnson is shooting out of his mind today.
Oh. Ow.
Oh. You might as well call him
Butler.
Above the rim.
That's Darian Butler out of the School of Recording Arts.
Wow, what a player.
Another dunk.
Well, team knowledge once again down by eight.
Josh Collins with the
nice hook shot there.
That's nice play by Abdusalan Osman from St. Paul Academy.
With the rebound, the first offensive rebound, I believe, of the game.
That's a foul. But another bucket for Butler.
What do you think of the defensive effort out here?
I don't think there is any. It's definitely different in the girls' game, that's for sure. There is not much defense being played out here.
I mean,
right
we've
now.
Had a score of 45-37 with almost 6 minutes left to go.
In a running time game, oh, he got fouled shooting a three.
What a smart play, Jarvis Johnson.
Jarvis got the benefit of being Jarvis Johnson.
put the ball up.
He misses the first free throw. And he shots his second free throw with his left hand. Misses that one too.
They're having a good time out here.
How do you, how have you heard of the plans or what Coach Pitino has in store for Jarvis next year? Is he plan on playing him a lot right away? Or?
Well, I know for sure he'll be one of the leaders of the point guards. And I mean, his basketball IQ is out of this world. It really is. They caught the basket off.
You can't do that.
Shot the free throw. And
yeah, that's a lane violation.
Not sure if he was trying to, what he was trying to do with that, but maybe he thought he was, playing with the
hand. He didn't get any buckets on any of those free throws.
That might have been a way for him to get a sub. I'm not sure.
Yeah, that's what he was trying to do. Oh, we have back in the game.
Got massive substitutions going on again.
Nice finish.
That was Jerome Dixon, I believe, once again. Armstrong.
Bro Powell for three.
Nice box out.
Here's Butler. Oh, Butler misses that one. So, yep. Definitely going to try to get these numbers taken care of at halftime. As of right now, 45-39, team wisdom over team knowledge. You know, the pace of this game is up and down, as it is every year. This fast-paced ball game.
What a steal. Great defense by
Ball stolen right
back. They're finally playing some defense, both teams. Starting to get a little bit more competitive here. But, I mean, if you look at the score right now, we've got 84 points on the board already.
Oh, on three.
Excuse me. Let's make that 87 points. That's already. Unbelievable.
And it's running time. So that's 87 points in literally 10 minutes of play.
Team Wisdom is up by 9.
Oh, that should have been a foul there. No call.
Looks like the energy level from Team Knowledge is just not there today. It's kind of interesting watching
three.
Oh my God. What a shot by, was that Rama?
Rama Hudnell.
I believe his sister played for De La Salle. He comes from a good basketball family. Uh-huh. Great shooter. That Minneapolis Henry this year. Time his shot is short. Nice
and
drive and finish this by John Warren.
This is getting out of control. Team Knowledge needs to step up their intensity, like you said. It's definitely not forward for three.
There you go.
But you know, in an all-star game, it could change just like that.
He just heard you. Right? Just pulled for three. They're down by 11.
Right to the basket. Nice move.
I've heard a lot about this Marshawn Wilson from Bill Murray.
He really likes to score the ball. He's really a scorer.
And he's very quick. Very quick player.
Strong.
I'm not sure, but it looks like Team Wisdom might be too athletic for Team Dallas. Now, I could be wrong. I mean, the passing, the offensive rebounds, they're getting, it's a one and done on the other end there.
One and done.
Once again, they're up by 15 points. Almost looks like Team Dallas doesn't want to play.
Yep. Team Dallas is just not in the ball game right now. It's 4-for-3 with the air ball again.
And the ball is still alive. Good save by Powell. He's saying, come on, guys, let's play. Uh-oh. Coach McKenzie is hot.
He said,
all-star gamer now. You know what? We're going to start playing some basketball. He's not having it.
Yeah, but down.
He's not used to getting beat by 15 points. He's not appreciating that. No. He's looking at his guys like, listen.
You know, because you're a competitor as anything else.
He said, I don't care what the score is. He is telling these guys off. You would think this was Minneapolis North right now.
Yep. I would, too, because it's embarrassing to go out and get blown out when you are perceived to have the better players,
Well, this
is true. He has Jalen Mobley, he has Jarvis. You know, he has Josh Collins. You know, he has Jabril Powell. He has, you know, four Division I basketball players on his team.
That's amazing. But, you know, you can have all the good talent in the world. You got to play basketball.
Got to play. You got to play. Jarvis Johnson with the ball. Right to the basket.
And
whoa,
one.
What a move.
What a strong finish. Jarvis Johnson with the and one. Nice quick move with the left and the soft kiss off the glass. Unbelievable.
Jarvis Johnson is a special, special player. I gotta say, I'm competing against him in the same conference last year. I'm not sorry to see him go to college, that's for sure.
Once again, we're not getting back down on defense. Team knowledge has got to play some defense. They got to get back.
Jarvis Johnson with the ball again. What's he going to do with it? Nice pass.
It looks like a little bit too much passing this time.
Over.
A little bit too much passing.
Nice finish.
Team got to get back down on defense. They got to get back down on defense.
They got to get back on D.
Oh, my God. You got to finish. You got to make the layups.
Jalen Mobley with that miss.
Oh, nice
and
move.
And finish finally on the play by Sean Burns out of Armstrong.
They're playing some defense now.
45 seconds
game.
Left to go in the half.
They have 61 points. This is unbelievable.
Oh,
unbelievable.
That was a deep, deep three-pointer.
Unbelievable.
Josh Collins to Jalen Mobley.
Nice
and the
pass.
Finish.
They got 30 seconds. Team Wisdom has 61 points. That's a game for some people. Looks like they're going to slow it down, take one shot. Team Knowledge needs to at least get the ball back and see if they can do something. And they're not going to call a five-second call, it looks like.
Okay, with double team. Uh-oh, for three.
And he's off.
Off.
Oh, no rebounding. Where's the rebounding? Unbelievable.
Whoa.
Shot won't
Buckets
count,
no
they didn't
good.
Get it off on time. We had poor rebounding, poor execution down the stretch. They did close the gap just a little bit. They're only down by 13 points.
So the halftime score is Team Wisdom 61, Team Knowledge 48.
Unbelievable, unbelievable.
It was a very fast-paced first half. The defensive intensity, I think Team Knowledge came out a little too cool, as you say. They didn't have the intensity level it took to compete.
This is an unbelievable game. You know, I mean, who would have thought you'd have 107 points, literally, by halftime?
But yep, they are scoring the ball. Like I said, in that first game, they was competing a little harder defensively. And so in this game, it's definitely a little bit less defense. There's Crystal Taylor. She came in the building. There's
Well, it looks like they got the skills again for the boys. Are they going to do the dunk contest this year or not?
I don't think there's a dunk contest. I just see the skills.
Unbelievable. Now, I tell you what, we're going to be missing out on that. And I admit the last couple of years, the dunks haven't been the greatest, but still, it really still is fun to watch.
Yes, it is.
It's still an exciting deal.
And this girl's over here putting on a show dancing over there.
Once again, we got a pretty good crowd. Thanks for coming out, everybody, and supporting the Inner City All-Star Basketball Classic. This is an amazing event put on by Derek Rubin 22 years ago.
61-48 is your halftime score.
And there's Jarvis Johnson's mother there in the peach color.
Yep.
Talking to, I think, Marshawn
Wilson's
mother.
Okay.
Yes.
Okay.
They're pretty good friends. Yeah, so it's kind of interesting. All the basketball moms, you know, they start to become friends after a while.
In AAU, and they see each other so much at tournaments and games. And
so this is exciting. So at halftime, we got skills, and the guys, you know, the 22, I think 22.9 was the top
20.4.
Oh, 20.4. Let's just see, in comparison, how quicker, if they're quicker, the guys are
than the girls. Because the girls, I mean, basically, if you don't make that shot,
yeah.
You know, the big thing is the shot. The guys will be quicker going through, but if they don't make the shot, then,
So what are you trying to say? Girls are, and I like that. Girls are the better shooters.
They can be, no doubt about it. It depends, you know, I don't believe it's a gender thing, it's a player thing. There's certain girls that are better shooters than certain boys. You know, so if you're a good shooter, you're a good shooter. It don't matter what gender you are. Who is that there?
There's my brother with Arian. His girlfriend.
Oh, okay.
Arian Ferrar Sr. and then my brother Anthony. It's kind of interesting. You talked about the Johnsons.
The Johnsons. There's so many of you.
And I'm pregnant. No.
Oh, my God. Again.
No. Here we go. We get started here.
And that's one thing that the boys, see how cool he's like. Girls are going harder. He's not going real hard.
And he barely got it through. And you know what? We're at 14 seconds, and you're right.
Yep.
I mean, they are much quicker, and he's just casual, doing this casually, and
see,
missed
they don't
the shot.
Make the shot, and then.
Because is it kind of like being too cool?
Yeah. I mean, he could have done that in 13 seconds if he would have tried hard. You know?
And that's what's really interesting.
Mm-hmm.
Is just, you know, how I think guys, for some reason, seems like they're a little bit more, like, shy.
Yeah, I
think it's more selective. They're on display.
Yeah, it's more of a self.
So now you got the dance contest here.
You got the dance contest going on.
Apparently they're not that entertained with our halftime entertainment.
Okay, Jacarius Ford is going quicker now. He's going quicker.
But he forgot the ball.
But he forgot the ball, so not costing big time.
Let's see if he can finish under 20 seconds. But the teardrop.
And they're shooting floaters instead of regular layups, which isn't helping.
And he will. Oh, he missed the shot, just like you talked about.
Yeah.
And you notice now he's taking the shot that he's supposed to take. But he took the shot before, beyond the three. Oh, my God. He's just going to give up now. This is what I'm talking about, Steve. In terms of, I think the guys are a lot shyer about this. And so he just kind of walked away after he missed a couple of shots.
Yep. You know, it exactly. It's
a little more ego involved.
It's definitely about that shot. If you don't make that shot.
And you talked about that.
And
one
those
of the
girls
you
made,
about.
Yeah, the girls made that shot. The first shot, the first time they took it.
You see the quickness, and I love this pace. He's got a nice pace here that he's going at now.
Why are they shooting floaters instead of letting
well, it's supposed to be a teardrop.
Oh, it's supposed to be a teardrop.
Oh, that's
right. Yep. Okay.
And you see he focuses here. Oh, he still misses. Unbelievable.
No, not one boy has beat Lyric yet.
Oh, my God.
Not one boy.
They are missing. Oh, come on. Get in there. Thank you. Thank you. Now, see, after doing all this, now what's happening?
I think Arian Ferrar is going to win this. I think he's going to fly through it and get like 15 seconds.
Well,
because he seems like the kind of kid who goes hard all the time.
And is focused. And then, you know, the biggest key here is everybody now, because there have been so many people that have missed shots before them. Now they're a little gun shy.
He's going fast, though.
Yeah.
Now he may do something now. Jabril's got some skill. Well, he's flying through. Look at him. He's getting through.
And he's a fundamental, you know, he's a good shooter. He's very, very fundamentally sound, as you can see. I believe this guy here is going to be your winner here.
But the shot didn't
shot
go.
Shot was short. Made the second one.
So no one has still, no one has beat Lyric Williams.
Now, does he have the
he has the fastest time for the boys.
Okay, 21.9. And there was two girls that.
Two girls beat that. No, one girl beat that.
One girl, okay.
Then somebody else got 22, I think.
22. Arian Ferrar. See, he's smart. He's going to go fast on the other steps here. That's the smartest thing to do is go quick. If you miss a shot, then you can catch up. See, he's going through those drills like it's nothing.
Yeah, he was my pick to win this. Oh, he made
See,
it.
See, here he goes. Now he's got a lot of time.
Nice
if he misses.
Make a shot.
You were right.
And he stopped
Arian
the three.
Ferrar.
You know,
my nephew. I hate to say it, but that's my nephew.
I should have put some money down on it. I told you who was
That's what I'm
win.
Talking about. My nephew right there. You heard it here first. All
is
in the family.
Nephew.
All in the family.
But I picked him to win.
Yeah, you did. I got to give you credit for that. 19.6, the fastest time of the day.
Of the day.
See, there you go.
Finally.
Take some pride. He said he watched all this. He did his good scouting report.
Yep.
And fundamentally sound, you're right.
Mm-hmm.
And you're right. He's the type of kid.
He works hard. Scouting him and watching him play throughout the season. Being a boys coach, I see them play a few times scouting their team. And he, plays hard.
He does.
Plays with a lot of intensity all the time.
Yes, he does. And I was watching a video with him at Ball Handling Billy earlier today, and boy, you know, what a work ethic. And he's, you know, kids that are like that, they're only going to get better. If you consistently, girl or boy, it doesn't matter. If you consistently work hard, you are going to get better.
No doubt.
And that is, you know, our young people really have to understand that. There's a lot of AAU and different things that they're doing. But the truth of the matter is, it boils down to practicing on your individual skills yourself. Nothing wrong with a trainer, but you need to go get to know yourself as an athlete.
No doubt, and I totally agree with that. I mean, you know, it's working out with the young men in the summer, you know, because we have, you know, we can coach our kids during the summer at this point. And it's all about skills. And tell them, I mean, if Steph Curry, the most skilled player in the world, works on his skills every day, then why shouldn't you?
I tell you what, he is the most amazing. You know, just watching him in warm-ups, he does these ball handling drills, what, I think 30 minutes or so.
I mean, he is the most skilled player. I mean, just the flat-out skills. LeBron's the best player, the most dominant player. But as far as skills, there's no one touching Steph Curry. He is amazing.
He is amazing.
Amazing skills.
And he's been fun to watch, especially for the little guys, the little point guards, you know. And he just gets it done.
He gets it done. He does.
But conditioning is a huge part of this game. Conditioning and strength. And, you know, and just with that, it builds confidence. Most people don't realize the harder you work, the more confident you become. And I was telling somebody, I've been coaching for over 20 years. I'm so tired of hearing about girls not having confidence. If you don't have confidence, girls, get in the gym. Get in the gym by yourself. Go work on your individual skills. Develop yourself. You know, you have to, you know, get your own confidence. Confidence cannot, it's not something you can buy. It can't be given. It's something that is within. There's Crystal Taylor right there. Crystal Taylor, the trainer, going back to North. That's her alma mater.
That's her alma mater.
Okay. But that's right. I can't hate her for that, right?
North, the best, the greatest school of all time.
I know. And I missed it tremendously. But I'm so glad it's in the hands of Crystal Flint. And two of my alumni are coaching with her, Tisa Thomas, Rocky Moore, and Crystal Taylor.
That's awesome.
What an honor.
Yeah, Crystal is an outstanding coach. She'll do a great job. She'll do a great job. I'm proud to say, I believe I gave her her first head coach, her first high school coaching.
Wow.
She was my assistant at Irondale when I was coaching the girls at Irondale.
And you know what's really interesting about that is that also puts some age on you, Troy.
Oh, I'm very old. I coach when I coach with you as your assistant.
That's right.
I coach Crystal.
I believe. Oh my God.
Yeah, Crystal. Yes. Crystal when she was a freshman.
I think you were
before you brought up to varsity.
You were my first assistant, weren't you?
I was your first JV coach.
Oh my God, that's amazing.
I own.
That's amazing. And then you left me.
Then I left you.
Doing your own thing.
It was definitely, I definitely had a great time coaching with you back then. That was definitely a good, good couple of years there.
Yes, that was a lot of fun. So, like, I got a question for you. What do you think is going to happen this second half? I mean, Team Wisdom came out with a bang. Do you think that they still have the legs? Do you think Team Knowledge is going to go on this significant run, or what do you think is going to happen here?
I think plenty. I think they're going to have a good run. I think they're going to work hard. And I think that that they're going to make this a competitive game. I have the head coach and also an MVP, alumni MVP, Rob Mestis, who is the head boys basketball coach at Roosevelt, also an Intercity All-Star Classic MVP. Rob, how you doing today, man?
I'm all right, Troy. How you doing, man?
Man, that's great, man. I saw you come here. I was like, man, I got to have Rob sit down. You know, you have a number of young men playing today. You know, tell me a little bit about your guys you got out here today.
Well, it's funny because there's a lot of kids that I'm learning about for the first time, but the Roosevelt kids, of course, that's who I came to see. London, you know, he quietly got about 13 to 15 points, London Cobbs, and Arian Ferrara is built for this kind of game, you know, the flashy all-star type of game, so I'm looking for him to have a big half, the second half.
Awesome, awesome. Man, congratulations on your season. You had a great year, make it all the way to the section finals on your first, in your second year at Roosevelt. Tell me a little bit about what you got going on, you know, as far as growing your program for next year?
You know, I'm just hoping that we're nice dunk right there.
Jarvis.
I'm hoping that we can continue to build a culture of commitment and accountability, man. That's kind of my goal. I kind of got rid of a lot of the guys that were there before I got there, man, and tried to build my own program. You know exactly how it goes.
Yes,
we're doing very similar things, man.
Uh-huh.
I'm proud of our basketball community that we have, man. And I'm just hoping to continue to build at Roosevelt.
Exactly. And I was proud of watching you guys play hard. You guys play great defense. It was just fun watching you guys play this year. What has this experience? Now, you were the MVP in this game back, I ain't gonna say what year, because I know I'm gonna tell your
95.
Age.
95. I'm an old man, yeah.
95, you were the MVP. What did that experience do for you, catapulting you into your college career?
You know, this game, and I tell people all the time, this game, there was and it's still very good, but at one point in time, this was the game in the Midwest that it was the game. And
uh-huh.
So to compete against the state's best players, I mean, the Minneapolis City Conference was the conference. All the players from Minneapolis, St. Paul, and the metro area played in it. So if you can compete against guys like that and get MVP, I knew I was ready for the next level. And that's why I use this as a very, as a catapult, like you said, to get to the next level, man.
Now, are you planning on, what is your long-term goals, man? Are you planning on sticking with Roosevelt for years to come, or do you plan on moving on to the college level, or
you know,
what is your long-term goal?
You know, I'm almost
there?
40, and I always wanted to coach college basketball, but for me, 5 kids, married, it'd be hard for me to go somewhere and be a director of basketball operations. So as much as I would like to go coach college basketball, I just don't see that happening.
Mm-hmm.
Roosevelt is the place where I'm excited. It's my dream job, really, to be at my own high school.
Uh-huh.
So hopefully I could be there for a long time and maybe put some championship banners, because there hasn't been any since 1955.
Well, we definitely thank you for your support of being an alumni who's always given back and supported the program. And good luck to you, man. Good luck to you in the future. Good luck next season. And hopefully we can see more of each other soon.
Yeah, man, and good luck to you too, man. I know you got a monster squad coming back, man. I appreciate you for getting me on here, man.
I appreciate it. All right, Rob. It's always good talking to you, man. All right. That's Rob Mestis, Minneapolis Roosevelt alumni, Miami of Ohio basketball legend also. Played with Wally Szczerbiak in college. And while we were away, we've been seeing some outstanding play from Team Knowledge.
Oh, my God. They have been off the chain. It has been flat out amazing.
Oh! Jarvis Johnson.
Now they're playing the basketball. It's a 5-point game.
You know,
Coach McKenzie is fired up right now.
Didn't I just say that before I took the interview that I knew for sure they were going to turn it on? They got too many competitors over there. I mean, you know, you got Jarvis Johnson, who, in my opinion, you know, if he had played at any other school besides LaSalle, where he, you know, could share the wealth and just be a point guard. If he had played at a school like for me or something, he would have averaged 30 points a game. I really believe he has that kind of game where if he was at a situation like that, he could average 30 points a game. He's that kind of player. I mean, he really has that kind of ability. But being at a place like LaSalle, where they had so many great players, and his job was to be the point guard and win, was his job, and he did his job. He won.
Wow.
That's what he was.
Well, they forfeited. That was amazing.
Yeah.
You know,
well,
Larry McKenzie is another. You know, they had been have no forfeit since Larry McKenzie's Henry teams.
Well, you know, because that's what he was there to do, was win, and that was his job, and he did it every year he was there. Arian Farrar with the ball, Roosevelt kid,
showing his ball handling skills.
Shot the three.
Oh, the rebound. A little bit short. Josh is on the boards, I tell you. He controls the boards. Jarvis Johnson relies a lot on him controlling the boards.
Nice, strong move.
Like it was nothing.
Man, that's a nice
change of pace. The no-look, the off-look. It's a three-point game right now. Unbelievable.
People talk a lot about speed, but it's change of pace, man. You can be fast, but if all you can do is go fast, that's not, you know, hard to defend. Being able to change speeds like he just did.
Well, they're coming in
tough.
Some massive substitutions now.
Oh, look at that dunk.
Massive substitutions now.
That was Marshawn Wilson out of Hill Murray with that monster dunk there.
Wow, unbelievable. That's unbelievable.
Jalen Mobley for three.
Just short. Arian Farrar.
Arian Farrar to the basket.
Oh,
a little
too much on that. They got massive subs going on now. Since that run, they said, you know what, forget this. You're going out there with the guns. Same thing, now we got substitutions as well.
Now let's see if this second team, that's where they've been getting in trouble. The second team's come in with a lack of energy and a more of a I'm too cool attitude. They need to come out and play hard in this, or this lead's gonna go back up again.
It's gonna be real interesting to see how this goes. Team Wisdom, our Team Knowledge worked extremely hard to get back into this game.
And we got LaWall with the ball.
Nice passing.
For three, no good. Nice rebound.
You know, they got major hops on this Team Wisdom's team. These guys can get up, unbelievable.
Oh, foul.
And you know, if he'd have turned around, he'd have took a charge.
Yep.
Turned around, he said, I don't want none of that.
No parts of taking a charge in All-Star game. That's one thing I despise the coach. A player that moves out of the way of a charge, don't take a charge, you got to come sit next to me.
That's right.
You got to take charges if you want to play defense.
Unbelievable.
Yep. 65-60, Team Wisdom is still ahead, but it's a much closer ball game. Now.
Jerome Dixon brings the ball up.
Another turnover.
Balls off of Justice Murphy from Johnston.
And there'll be a TV timeout here in the game. Gonna be a timeout. Gonna be an announcement by the Minnesota Chill basketball program.
There's a timeout on the floor.
The timeout on the floor. The Minnesota Chill is one of the sponsors of the Inner City All-Star Class this year. And they're going to talk a little bit about their program.
Looks
I
like
was looking to maybe possibly get a couple more interviews here. And, you know, why do you think Team Knowledge was able to get back in this ball game?
Well, Coach McKenzie had a nice, I'm sure, halftime talk with these young men. And prior to the end of the first half, he just said, listen, you know, this is an All-Star game, but this is about pride, too. I mean, you guys are athletes. You were chosen. You were here as All-Stars. And the bottom line is not about, you know, going out there and trying to showboat, but it's like at the same time, you were chosen for a reason, so respect that and respect the game. He probably told him to respect the game.
Yeah, exactly. And I think that the pride, you know, like a play, like you said, players like Jarvis and Josh, they're used to winning. They're not you know, they're not losing, you know, just without giving a effort.
Oh no, not at all.
Yeah, so you know, it's gonna be a tight game going down the stretch. I think down the stretch when he leaves his, you know, when the best players against best players down the stretch, when you got a guys in, that's gonna be fun to watch. I can't wait to see the last 5 minutes of the game.
Yeah, that's
going to
be
lots of fun.
Well, the chemistry there, you know, you got Josh and Jarvis on the same team, but, you know, when you have an exciting point guard that has high basketball IQ, you know, he's quick reading the players on his team, so he knows his players and he knows how to get them the ball, you know, where they want it. And so, I mean, it really boils down to having great point guards in this day and age. You really need a good point guard.
Trying to get Rashad Vaughn's attention here. He was an alumni.
Who's entering into the draft this year.
Entering into the NBA draft this year. He's walking in, but we can get. Yep. So, you know, we need one of those spotter people to go around and grab folks for us. Rashad Vaughn, Inner City All-Star Classic alumnus.
Well, I hear those combines are pretty pretty tough, the workouts there. Looks like he's in great shape.
Yep.
So it would be awesome to get him and actually ask him what that's been like. And, you know, while he's preparing for the NBA, it would be a great, nice shot right there.
Yep.
Oh, God.
And what would it mean to pick by the Timberwolves, man, and be able to stay home and play just in front of your own.
That would be amazing. Nice drive. We got some defense now. We're picking up the defense. Well, it looked like we're about to pick up full court.
69-62.
You're going to keep the gap close here. to make it so hard when the other crew comes out. This team has kind of been the ones lagging a little bit.
Got, oh, nice
and
rebound.
They're just dominating on the boards.
That was a beautiful rebound.
That was.
Marquise Walker.
Did he sky for that? Unbelievable. Oh, my God.
Turnover.
The defensive effort there. Team Wisdom is extremely athletic. Look at the finish there. Cat quick right there. My God. That John Warren
back
from
up,
Hopkins.
Back up nine. Like I said, when they put that second group in, they have not competed like that first group. There we go.
I think he got a little break from the rim there. The rim's a little soft.
Got it up there nice and soft. 71-64 is now the score. For three. Short.
That's a tough move for a lefty. You know,
make a bounce pass, get up the ball. Oh,
well,
too late.
The thing was, no, he wanted the 3-point shot. You notice that his angle was poor. If he'd have cut to the basket, he would have had a layup. You know, but most of these guys, you know, they want to get the 3-point shot. And they're not even, oh my God, he got that just pounced on. Oh my God, unbelievable. A little bit too high.
A little bit
bounds,
too high on the pass.
Too much.
Jacarius Ford coming back in.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable. Looks like Dwayne Bird, our commentator,
yeah,
is telling him to get off.
He is not impressed with what's going on out there right now.
It's a 7-point game. It's an opportunity.
Oh,
oh my God.
Wow.
Looks like he just threw that up there. Oh my goodness, unbelievable. This is right here. Jerome Dixon Armstrong way off in the mark that time.
71-64. The scoring has really slowed down from the first half. Oh.
Wow. He had to reach back for that.
Reach
what a
back.
Nice,
I know. Nice finish.
And effort.
That was a very nice finish by Butler.
Oh,
Butler's got a
split the two. Oh, my God.
Look at Ford.
There you go.
Ford.
Unbelievable. Now we're talking. Jacarius Ford from Henry. They should have had a pretty good game, this team this
oh,
year.
Oh, and one. And
they're
one.
They're coming right back at him. Right back at him.
...75-66 with the nice, strong move. I believe that's John Warren of Hopkins.
We're gonna have some substitutions at this point. We're down by 10.
Back down by 10.
You know, it's the defensive effort, you know? You just gotta go out there and play and have fun, you know?
Well, you know, I think they're up there, but they're not scoring the basketball and like the first group is scoring the basketball. Powell for three. I wish he had shot like that when he played against us. He couldn't miss a shot. He played Washburn. It was unbelievable. I've never seen a team that hot before in my life.
Wow.
They would not miss.
And they had a pretty good season this year, too.
They had a good year. They had a good year.
It is so competitive this year. It's just,
it is
so, and which is really great to see, but competitiveness, the state of Minnesota for men and women's basketball is just outstanding.
It has been. Jarvis Johnson to the basket again.
With an and one.
And one.
He's just too quick, and he stretches the floor. If you see how he drives to the basket, he stretches. He uses his arms and legs to stretch it out and still maintain control of the basketball.
It's just, you know, we work on a drill on getting to the basket with one dribble. A lot of guys have to take two or three dribbles. He gets to the basket. He's getting to the basket from the three-point line to the basket and with one dribble. And that's, you know, and that's hard to defend.
Yeah, it is. Yes, it is. What a whoa! What a good defensive effort right there. Unbelievable. Unbelievable effort right there defensively.
Jarvis Johnson.
He's on
three.
Fire!
He is on fire!
You
know, I truly believe.
He wants it.
I truly believe he could have averaged 30 a game this year.
Jarvis Johnson wants it.
He is on fire.
He wants it.
It's
I tell you, look at
game.
He even got a rebound. I haven't seen that too often. That's my nephew. He even got a rebound.
Oh, turned it over.
The defensive effort right there from behind.
Butler, oh, fouled by Josh Collins.
Wow. He was going to do something special with that. He got around him. He was tipped from behind. Unbelievable.
Jalen Mobley checking back in. One heck of a ball player and football player from St. Paul Johnson High School.
That was a great effort from Jakarius Ford. He was the only one keeping him in the game as the second crew.
Yeah, he was playing very well.
Great defensive effort.
Man, Osman is really being a presence in there with his length.
Yes, he is. He's got long arms, and he keeps his hands up. Whoever taught him, as a coach to block shots, I mean, unbelievable job. It's credit. Give the young man credit as well for working hard. But it's rare that you see a good shot blocker like that anymore.
Oh, nice shot.
Oftentimes, that's determination.
Powell with the pull-up.
Oh, nice shot.
Nice shot by Powell.
You see that coming the whole way.
Yep.
He was determined. It's only a four-point game.
Four-point game. They're competing.
They came back on that right away. Unbelievable.
Nice pass in there by Team Wisdom.
Nice defense
Mobley.
There.
Mobley.
I like the left there. He fooled him the whole way there to the basket. Unbelievable. Nice move.
Nice finish.
He was really trying to get the and one with that.
Yep.
Nice smooth finish with the left. The right side. It's tough to do.
Oh, nice skip out.
Oh.
Three.
Nice shot. Eric Elliott from...
Eric Elliott Johnson.
That's off. You can tell that's just off just a little bit. Nice first offensive rebound, I believe. Nice effort
Osman.
There.
Oh.
In and out. 5-point game. They got to keep up the intent. Oh, my God, the run right here.
Butler with another finish. Butler is out. If Team Wisdom wins, I believe Butler's going to get the MVP.
Well, I tell you, what happens is they have to put forth so much energy. Jarvis Johnson.
Jarvis Johnson.
My God, it's a 4-point game.
Chantrell Henderson.
Jarvis Johnson
from the Buffalo Bills.
Fire today. That's a big guy. I can see why he's from the Buffalo Bills. He is a big dude.
He played in the Inner City All-Star Classic alumni.
For basketball?
Basketball.
Wow. So he's a basketball and a football player.
Yes, always.
Oh, my God.
Yeah, more football than basketball.
I can see that he looked like he would just destroy someone.
Yes, he wound up finishing his career at the University of Miami playing football. And played for the Buffalo Bills last year. Late round draft pick who wound up starting most of the year. Had an awesome football season at left tackle for the Buffalo Bills.
Jarvis Johnson missed the first in front end of that. And,
Jarvis hasn't made a free throw yet.
he
can make threes, anything else, but the free throw's not going for him.
He
today.
Did make one earlier.
He made one earlier?
He made early. That's his second, I believe, or his third.
I know he had shot the three free throws when he got fouled shooting the three.
Oh, that's right. Oh, yeah, that's right. He was playing around there.
But he was playing around with it. Yeah, he wasn't trying to make those.
Nice offensive rebound, though.
He says, well, oh.
I can't make the three.
I'm going to make a free throw. I'm going to make a three for you. Collins for three.
Oh, my goodness.
Nice rebound by Ferrar. Oh, trying to throw it between Jarvis's legs.
That's his cousin.
His cousin.
So he knew that was going to happen. So we got five minutes left in the game, almost 6 minutes left. And it's a 4-point game. So depending on how Coach McKenzie decides to do this, you know, he might feel like, you know what, listen, this is a privilege and this is an honor to be here.
Yeah, exactly.
I know this is an all-star game. I'm supposed to play for everybody at the same time. I'm a basketball coach.
Exactly.
So it's going to be real interesting to see what he decides to do.
Coach Pete out there coaching. It'd be nice to We have the nice crowd here at the Inner City All-Star Classic. 83-79 is your score. Arian Ferrar.
We all set for the last 5 minutes of the game, so it's going to be real interesting.
Oh, and it's stolen.
Steal. Nice defense. Oh, my God.
He lost the ball. He was
coming.
Josh Collins finishes it.
That's the same thing he used to do at De La Salle. He's right there on top of it. He knew something fishy was happening. He said, you know, I don't like the way this is looking.
It is a two-point game.
Wow, unbelievable. The defensive effort right here, unbelievable. Good block. Wow. Jarvis Johnson.
What's Jarvis going to do with it?
You know he's going to do something. You can just tell. Look at the outstanding cross-court bounce pass.
Oh,
unbelievable.
He got fouled by Mobley. And
nice finish.
Jalen Mobley.
Nice finish. Oh, my God.
83-83 is
wow. Jarvis Johnson, now he's clapping. He's clapping his team up. He's clapping his team up. Cousin against cousin. What's going to happen here? Good defense. Cousin against cousin.
Oh.
Oh, my God. What's going to happen? Oh!
He threw it between his leg. He threw it between Burns' leg.
He got out of that trap. He was determined to get out of that trap.
And he got a bucket for his team.
They made him work for that one.
What a display.
They made him work for that
one. But Jarvis is going to pull the three. I knew it. I knew he was going to pull the three.
Oh, Jarvis Johnson's on fire.
I knew he was going to pull the
three. Can't be stopped today. What has he got, 30?
He's got a whole bunch of their lot.
40,
86, 85. What
wow, unbelievable,
game.
Unbelievable. Unbelievable effort by Jarvis Johnson. Man. Unbelievable. Wow. This has been exciting.
Uh-oh, what's
Team
gonna
Knowledge
happen
got
here?
A second win. Is he gonna
for
make
three.
That?
Oh.
Get in there.
Josh
the
Collins
effort.
With the rebound.
Look at Josh.
Oh,
what a monster in there.
Burns back up.
Come
Burns.
On. Oh, my God.
Burns
the effort on
it.
There.
Jalen Mobley.
Wow.
He's so strong.
Nice
Burns with
through.
The finish. It looks like Team Wisdom's getting a little discouraged here, tired. They better get some subs. 88-85 is your score. Arian Ferrar with the ball. They're gonna get some subs here. Arian Ferrar for three, no good.
Wow.
Jalen Mobley with another rebound. Looks like he's gonna go to the basket and pulls up. Finds Jarvis, oh no, doesn't find Jarvis. Oh, Jarvis with a
unbelievable. Jarvis Johnson with the effort. Wow. Unbelievable. Unbelievable. He is playing like this could be his last. Unbelievable. What an effort by Jarvis Johnson today. Back to his buddy. Boy, do you see the switch here? All of a sudden, the momentum change. Whoa. Look at this. All of a sudden, Team Wisdom
85.
Is deflated. It is, I can't even, what's the turnaround here? Is that like almost a 20-point turnaround or whatever? Man, unbelievable effort today. Unbelievable effort. This is the most amazing comeback I've seen, and this is just an amazing effort by the young man Jarvis Johnson and his crew. I tell you, I know that's my nephew, but I couldn't be any more proud of the way he's playing and willing his team back. Unbelievable effort. This has been absolutely amazing.
Absolutely.
Yes.
Absolutely. I mean, you know,
and I knew
he's too much of a competitor.
Yes, he is. I tell you, this has been a great game. And you know what? Team Wisdom has 61 points at half. They've only scored 24. That is unbelievable. 24 incomplete. Oh, it almost tipped in. Almost tipped in.
It's 92. Oh, whoa. Three.
Oh, my God. We got a four-point game with 2 minutes left. It's going to be like the girls' game. This can go down to the wire.
Go to the wire. What's Jarvis Johnson going to do with it?
looks like the same type of finish of the girls' game just about.
Collins!
Wow! The De La Salle Islander combination, unbelievable. I'm not trying to pump De La Salle, but it is what it is.
You ain't got to pump it to me.
It is what it is.
Because nice. I had three games against them this year.
Nice. That's a nice shot. Still, once again, a four-point game. They're not giving up. Team Wisdom is not giving up.
Jarvis
Still
Johnson.
Plenty of time. Plenty of time.
For three, short. Shot blocks. Rebound block, 95-91.
Oh,
and he's fouled, Buckley.
There's still plenty of time. He's fouled. He's going to the free throw line. We got a minute left to go.
That's Buckley out of cool racket.
And this is going to be down to the wire right now. Down to the wire. Man, unbelievable.
Unbelievable.
And he makes the first of two. It's been real interesting to see how, you know, how this goes.
They gotta hold on here.
Your shooter Powell back in the game. He is an amazing shooter.
Yeah, he can really, when he's open, I mean, when he's on, he is absolutely on.
Seconds left. Oh, a steal.
Uh-oh.
Oh my God, they get. Is he going to try to tie it up or be going? And one. Oh, 46 left to go. Man.
Buckley is having a heck of a finish to the game.
At first, he looked like he was going to take the three, and he did a nice little hesitation move there. And he's a good free throw shooter, so I don't blame him for driving to the basket. If you can put the free throws in, you know, and you might as well go ahead. There's still plenty of time left.
Your score, 93-95 with 46 seconds to go.
Denying Jarvis the ball. He's not letting him get the ball.
That makes a lot of sense. I will do the same thing. But in an all-star game, you know, that's that's kind of new.
Well, both teams are not in the bonus yet, so.
Oh, Powell better, almost got it stolen.
Yes, he got to hold on to the basketball. There's a foul right
there. Timeout, no call timeout. McKenzie calls timeout.
1-point game. They're going to look to get the ball back into Jarvis Johnson's hands, I'm sure. So, but they, you know, the talent now out there with that five, I mean, there's still a good group out there. Anyone can drive to the basket, and anyone can make it happen. So, it's going to be real interesting to see, you know, what happens here. Now, I don't know, the referees are...
I don't know what's going on out there. They're wondering where the ball is going to be thrown in at.
Well, it looks like both coaches are
Are on the floor
harassing
Pat official. Rock and his partner. Pat Rock is showing him his pockets is empty and somebody needs to pay him if they want this call.
And they're going at it again. You've got number 30, guarding Jarvis Johnson, and right here I can't find his number, but he's not letting him get the ball. What's up? So yeah. We got another. Looks like I got a team huddle with both teams in the huddle. I've never seen this before.
I believe that's Stephen Kennedy, number 30.
Where Coach McKenzie's got both teams in the huddle. These guys are competitive. I mean,
what is going on out here? This is the longest timeout in the history of timeout.
And an all-star game nonetheless. Unbelievable.
They got 45 minutes more of my time. Because I got to get home for the basketball
exactly.
game.
What time does that start today,
buddy? 7 o'clock.
7 today?
7
oh,
o'clock.
My God. You're right. I've got to see. They're back in Golden State today, too.
Back in Golden State, yep.
Well, I tell you, we've had fun here today, though. This has been a very exciting game this year.
It has been. This is lots of fun.
In both years, you know, both teams... They scored, you know, way over, you know, I mean, look at the score. 95-94.
That's almost 100 feet.
God, it's amazing. All the points put up in the All-Star. And that's the way really it should be. So
look, Stephen Kennedy looked like he's, I think that's Stephen Kennedy over there taking away Jarvis. but the steal. No bucket.
Did they call the foul? Did he call the foul? 6 seconds left. Oh, my God, 3 seconds left. 3 seconds left. They called the timeout. Timeout has been called. Look at the defensive effort right here. Unbelievable. Wow. I believe it's got more than 2 seconds left. But I think that's about 2.3 or 4 seconds left in this game. This is really tight. Man. This is an amazing finish here. I've lost my co-host here briefly, but man, you know, this is just unbelievable. So I'm not sure what's going to happen here, but it's interesting. 3 seconds on the clock. It could be anyone's game, so there's plenty of time. And neither team is in the bonus, so if I were Team Wisdom, I would look to foul for sure, because that would take off time off the clock. But these guys are quick, and in men's basketball, anything can happen. A couple of passes up the court. You mean half court in 1 second, so it's gonna be real interesting to see what happens here in the final 3 seconds of what has been an unusual and an amazing finish in today's game. Unbelievable.
Three seconds left to go, 96-95. Landon Cobb from Roosevelt is putting on a show also.
Well, they got the ball in half court, I see. So, man.
Oh, it is NBA rules. They gave him the ball in half court.
Jarvis Johnson saying he's too small. He's saying he's too small. I think they should run some type of loop double screen for him to get past, to get open. Sometimes those small guards are just like little gnats, though. Little gnats. Unbelievable.
I don't know what's going on out here. I don't know what the holdup is.
They put the tallest guy, Dr. Duncanstein, on Powell. Powell's got to back up a little bit so that he can at least see. So he can see the floor. I don't even think he can see the court. Once again, this is taking forever just to get the ball in bounds. Unbelievable. This is exciting. This is
great.
You know,
caught up in looking as a coach. I'm wondering what is going on right now. I'm just mesmerized by what are they doing. First of all, they changed the NBA rules on the fly. They give them the ball at half court.
This is true.
And then they put 3 seconds back on the clock.
And I don't know about you, but I can't even see the court. Are they? Everybody's standing. It's like standing room only. This is unbelievable. What an exciting finish.
And they switched Marshawn Wilson on to Jarvis.
They got to call a foul
here.
They
called a foul.
He got tripped. He got tripped on the play. Tell you what, that would have been a nice pass, so a nice play. Wow. That would have been a nice play. Wow, we almost had a layup here.
D-Bird wants an intentional foul.
Unbelievable.
No, he didn't. He didn't call no intentional foul on that. They need to skip the ball out of bounds again and get it started.
Well, it looks like because they're in the bonus now. They're not shooting the one-on-one right now. Or is he shooting the one-on-one?
We need to just get it going here.
They're taking it out of bounds again. They're taking it out of bounds once again. So
out of bounds.
Now it's 2.7 seconds. The next foul would be the shot. So
that was definitely a foul. He definitely got tripped. No doubt about that.
Wow. I think they should go for a backdoor alley-oop to Josh.
Josh, yeah. That's
there
you
go.
Do the referees need to come to the monitor?
All I can say is, oh my God.
What a play. What a play.
Oh my God. That was the most exciting thing. And you know what? I would take credit again. That was my nephew who passed that basketball. I'm going to, you know what?
A kid they made a bucket.
I'm just going to be excited about being related to these people. You know, maybe I don't have to coach another game. Maybe I just live off my relatives and live through my relatives.
And a kid that ain't made a basket all game long is the wins the game winner.
Oh my God, that was absolutely amazing.
Osmond with the layup to win the ball game.
Off that was
a pretty
amazing
play by Jarvis Johnson.
Wow.
Like I said, he's just a winner. He just
Jesus
wins.
Jesus Christ.
He just wins. Oh. He wins basketball
wow
game. He's just a winner.
What a pass, what a play.
What a play by Jarvis Johnson.
I mean, that was so much fun. Oh my God.
We're gonna show the last basket again. If anybody needs to see that it
wow
wasn't good, that
we gotta look at the monitor.
It
was out of his hands. Oh my God.
Right
at
the buzzer.
It was out of his hands.
It was right at the buzzer.
That was unbelievable.
Play.
Oh my God, what
a
finish is right. That was one of the funnest, most exciting All-Star games, I tell you, that we've seen.
It was a great game.
And
we're gonna see who got the MVP here.
We're hoping that everybody kind of just simmers down and at least appreciate the last part of this. You know, and
it got done early enough for me to get home and watch the game. I'm just loving this.
Exactly. That was so much fun.
That was a lot of fun. I tell you what, man. I admire watching that kid play for 4 years. And we'll definitely get him over here for an interview.
The MVP. Yes.
Yep. So, yeah,
wow,
man. Yeah.
Yes.
So, very, very interesting. So, we're
yes
still on. You know, Faith, tell me a little bit, you know, games are exciting like that. As a
yeah
coach, would you have put two people on Jarvis
yes
and not allow him to get the ball in his place?
Once he gets the ball in his hands, he's too quick at the ball and he's too savvy on the court. He sees the floor well.
You know,
and I tell you, he made, what a decision did he make from, you know, that pass. And how could you even find that pass? You know, that's absolutely unbelievable.
Yeah.
I mean, his family's got to be proud. I'm proud.
Yeah. I know you are. I know,
man,
you're very proud.
But this is exciting. I mean, this goes to show you just how good basketball is, how competitive people, you know, are in the state of Minnesota. I mean, this was such a great game. I mean, the athleticism from Team Wisdom.
You should go jump in that picture.
Man, seriously, that would be great, wouldn't it?
You should go do that.
I do want to be in that picture. I probably get a picture of these guys a little bit later. But
yep.
Definitely got to get a quick interview with Mr. Johnson.
Yeah, we'll definitely
well,
get
I see his dad's in
his
there
dad
with him.
Is in there.
Getting a picture. I don't blame his dad getting in there.
Yep, little brother.
Yeah,
little
man,
big,
it's
little
unbelievable.
Big brother. Not your little brother
wow
anymore.
Look, they look just alike today. That's cute.
Yeah.
His brother played for Henry. I don't know if you remember back in the day, he played for Henry. And
Curtison.
So,
oh, heck yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, no doubt. No doubt.
Oh, there's Alan
that
Anderson over there taking a picture with him. Oh, that's cute, man. Look at that.
That's awesome. That's a big-time memory
yeah
for Jarvis to have.
Yes. Yes, that's a and great guy.
Hopefully one day things work out. They'll be playing against each other.
That's what I'm talking
about. In the NBA.
Amen. Amen to that. That'd be awesome.
Yep, yep. I don't you know, like I said, I don't know how things will work out. You never know how they work out, but he's definitely talented enough to be there. There's no doubt about that. But we all know pro sports are a little bit more than about more than talent a lot of times, luck and opportunity and all that.
So. Absolutely.
But he's definitely talented enough to be in the NBA one day.
I think my brother is telling me to come down and take a picture. I'm not sure.
Yep, if you go down there, send Jarvis back up here.
Okay.
After you're done taking a picture with them.
Are they all taking pictures? Or are they all? Well, they look like
they're. It looks
I don't
like
think I can get down there fast enough. I ain't gonna lie to you. A little bit out of shape these days.
No, you stop it. Stop it. But anyways, yes, I enjoyed this year. It was a lot of fun. I enjoyed both games because both games were competitive. And like when you said at halftime, do I think Knowledge was going to be able to get back in the game? And I'm like, you know, with those guys that I coached against this year, knowing how competitive they are and how they absolutely hate to lose, I knew that they was going to get back in the ball game. You know, I know we played De La Salle at our place this year, and we were up at halftime. Well, we were down one at halftime. We were up in the second half by a couple points. And they're like, no, we're not losing. Next thing you know, the 15, 16-point game, they just refused to lose. They just are were a very talented group.
And that's, you know, and that comes from, you know, just discipline, but also the chemistry of that team was really unbelievable. Like you said, there's four Division I athletes on that team in itself.
Yeah. Well, and it comes from I mean, I'm small, so I'm partial to the point guards. But when you have a great point guard, you know, it is such an advantage to have the best point guard. You know, no matter what. I mean, you look at Apple Valley and when they had Tyus, and you look at Khaled. I mean, you look at all the great point guards in Minnesota. Their teams have always been winners because the point guard position in high school is so it's so valuable.
This is true, and I tell you what, if I had a a more athletic point guard the last two seasons, I would have it would have been amazing for me.
Oh, for sure.
I really feel like I would have been back at the state tournament.
I feel
that's
like
very important.
Yeah, I definitely believe my team would have been able to compete at a higher level had we had you know, a true point guard, you know.
Yeah, we're trying to get Jarvis Johnson over here. I know he's probably signed autographs and everything else.
Yeah, we need him to come over here.
Yeah, we can get Jarvis.
So, you know, we can get the interview and close the show here.
I can't even see him.
I don't see him, and he's not little. So I don't know why we can't see him, but he disappeared someplace there.
He did. That's unbelievable. We got to find him. You know, we could talk to, maybe Arian Farrar with the skills until he gets there, if I can find one of these guys.
Yeah, we could find somebody here to talk to, but we definitely need to get Jarvis so we can close the show. Oh, there he's over. I see him over. I see him over there.
In the corner?
Oh, okay.
Or is that his dad?
Well, you know what? We're going to have to close out here.
Jarvis
must have went to the locker room. I don't even think he's here anymore. Maybe he did not want to come on TV, which is understandable. I truly understand.
Yeah.
I truly understand him being exhausted and not wanting to be. So.
Yes. I keep asking everybody, is this it? But,
but again, we want to say thank you to everybody who was here watching, you know, the Inner City All-Star Classic. We want to thank everyone who was with us, everybody that supported us throughout the years and support this program, support SPNN. If you want to get a copy of this game, you can contact SPNN. I believe the phone number I saw earlier was 651-298-8906, and you could purchase a copy of this ball game. At that number. Again, the number is 651-298-8906.
You know, and I do want to say, Troy, real quick before you close out, you know, it's such an honor to be here, you know, doing this with you. You're so amazing. You do such a great job helping to, you know, find these athletes here in the state of Minnesota, and you know so much about them. You do your homework. So I just want to say thank you to you.
Well, thank you so much, Faith. I appreciate it. And for Faith Johnson Patterson, this is Troy Russell. Again, this is the 22nd annual Inner City All-Star Classic. Thanks everyone for supporting and coming out and watching. Thank you.